Dear students, I am Sahatan, working as a physics faculty in Target English Medium School. Today, in this part video, I would like to explain about what are the differences or distinguish between convex and concave mirror or concave and convex mirror. And after that, so I will explain clearly about. So is really R is equals to 2F is nothing but, so derivation for the R is equals to 2F is nothing but the radius of curvature is always twice than the focal length. Is it correct or not? We are explaining these two topics in this hot video from the chapter of reflection of light at a spherical or curved surface in 9th standard level in our state syllabus. Distinguish between concave and convex mirror. Concave and convex mirrors. So already in our previous videos I clearly explained that what is the concave, what is the convex, and what is their nature. And also with the convex and the concave will be forms which type of images and what is their nature, that is we know very clearly. Based on that one we discuss it in this time. Concave mirror convex mirror. Reflecting surface is inward. The reflecting surface is outward or bulging side. It acts as a converging mirror. It acts as a diverging mirror. A parallel beam of light after reflection meet or converge at a point. A parallel beam of light after reflection appears diverge from a point it forms both real and virtual images. It forms only virtual images. So next, fifth one. The magnitude of concave mirror, either greater, equal, means or equal, or lesser than the one, lesser than the field, the magnification of concave mirror, either more, greater, or equal, or less than the one. What is the magnification? I will explain clearly in the latter video. This side, the magnification produced by the convex mirror is always lesser than the one. Here, the magnification produced by concave mirror is either greater or equal or less than the one. But here, the magnification produced by convex mirror is always lesser than the one. M equals to So. H I upon H naught, that is lambda into lambda. Next, so next sixth point is, in searchlights, automobile headlights, and in projectors, mainly we are using the concave mirrors, convex mirrors. It is used as a rear view mirror. Listen very carefully. Convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror, but concave mirror is used in projector, automobile headlights, and searchlight. Is nothing but torchlights. In this one, concave mirror we are used as a reflector. So these are the six important differences or distinguish we are observing that. First one, the concave mirror. The reflecting surface is inward is called concave mirror. The reflecting surface is outward, we are called convex mirror. Concave mirror is acts as a converging mirror. Convex is acts as a diverging mirror. Why? We know that. So a parallel beam of light rays after the reflection, they really meet at one point. After a parallel beam of light rays, after the reflection, they appear to meet at other point or appear to diverge from a point, that is in case of convex mirror. Concave mirror forms both real and virtual images, but convex mirror forms only virtual image. The magnification produced by the concave mirror is either greater or equal or less than the one. The magnification produced by the convex mirror is always less than the one. So concave mirror is used in projectors, automobile headlights, and searchlights. Convex mirror is used in as a rear view mirror. So here in this one, principal focus is the real in concave mirror. Principal focus is virtual in convex mirror. Because of, I said, in front of the concave mirror, principal focus is there. But in convex mirror, the principal focus and the center of curvature will be there behind. That's why virtual. So principal focus is real for concave mirror. Principal focus is virtual for convex mirror. These are the main distinguish or differences between convex and concave mirror or concave and convex mirror. uses of concave and convex mirrors. Concave mirror used as a shaving mirror. I will tell exactly about this one in this part only. Concave mirrors are used as reflectors in projector lights, automobile headlights, searching lights, and torch lights. Convex mirror used as a rear view mirror, rear view mirror. In automobiles, it is also called side view mirror. Convex mirror used as a reflector in street lights. So these are the main uses of which one? Convex and concave mirrors. Listen very carefully. Concave mirror used as a shaving mirror. Shaving mirror means not the plain mirror. Okay, plain mirror is used as a looking glass, but in the shaving mirror separate are there. So why? Because of means when they shave the braid or so cut the mustache in a proper way, either braid or mustache, the hair on that one. So in the shaving mirror, it is also called as a dentist mirror. Okay, concave mirror is we write that one, fifth one. Concave mirror used as used by dentist. Therefore it is called dentist mirror. So shaving mirror means we know that in the last grade diagram, graphical representation for concave mirror, if the object is placed between the principal focus and the pole of the mirror, so the concave mirror will forms the image behind the mirror. It is the virtual, erect, and magnified image will be formed. That's why. So when you are doing the braiding, shaving the, during the shaving. So if the mirror will be placed here, so the hair will be appears very clearly. Means even is any hair will be not removed from the grid, we can easily remove. That purpose, we are using which one? Okay, concave mirror used as a shaving mirror. Next one, concave mirrors are used as reflectors in projector lights. Okay, means not in the cinema projector. In the cinema projector, we are using the convex lens. But in the which projectors? Normal projectors. Means, okay, we are using the slide projector like the type of one. In the slide projectors, mainly we are using the which one? Concave mirrors. And also automobile headlights. Automobile headlights. So automobile means, you know that in case of bike or car or any or truck or bus, in that one headlights are there. In the headlights, which are there, concave mirrors are used. So you are observing that, okay. It is the dome of the bike. Inside the dome of the bike, you are observing that. Like this one is there. For this one, you are observing that. Okay. Like this. So, for every bike, mostly you are observing that dome is there. Means like mirror light. Like this one. It is the transparent glass is there. It is the inside, a silver coated surface is there, like this curved shape. So that is the surface. So backside is coated with silver paint. It is the fine glass shape, okay, mirror shape is there. That's why it is which one? The reflecting surface is involved is called concave mirror. That's why. So this is the which mirror? Concave mirror. When the light will be coming from this one, will be fall, okay, from the bulb, this one, and also like this. That's why the part of the light will be fall directly on the mirror, on this one it will become. But fall on the mirror, it will be reflected to back. Again. Like this one. That's why, so for giving the more intensity of the light, for viewing the objects clearly, or vehicles clearly, on the road in front of you, we are using the which one? Concave mirror. Understanding? When you are using the concave mirror, okay, in the headlights of the automobile, what will happen? So you can increase the intensity of the light or decrease the intensity of the light. That's why you can able to see the object or vehicle in front of you clearly during the night time. Next one, in the searching lights. Searching light means large lights are there for searching the any things. Mostly in some of the movies you are observing that during the night time is any, okay. So prisoner, will be escaped from the prison. At that time, the police will be okay searching for them. And also in the torchlights also we are using the which one? Concave mirror. Next one, concave mirror used by dentist. Therefore, it is called dentist mirror. Okay. So the dentists are using a mirror. So that's why the mirror will be placed okay for the purpose of which one? Tooth decay. When for observing the tooth decay very clearly. So okay, the dentists are using which one? Concave mirror. That's why the concave mirror will be placed near the dent. Okay, our teeth. What will be happen? Okay. So at that time, our teeth is an object. It is behaves like two lies between principal focus and pole of the concave mirror. That's why the teeth image will be formed behind the mirror, is nothing but inside the mirror, and is in turn magnified. That's why small teeth is appears to larger size. Then the dentist doctor, means the dentist, can easily examine it. So where the tooth decay will be formed, a real tooth decay will be formed, and what is the position of the teeth like the type of one. Next, convex mirror used as a rear view mirror in automobiles. It is also called side view mirror. So in our bikes or any vehicles, you are observing that side view mirror is there. In the side view mirror, which is used convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror. Next one, convex mirror used as a reflector in street lights. So we know that in most of the cities, street lights are there. In the street lights, which mirrors we are using? Convex mirrors. Why convex mirrors are used in the street lights and the rear view mirrors? Means the field of view is more varied. That is one. the field of view is more. I will explain this for understanding of you. So first thing is, why plane mirror is not used as a rear view mirror? Why we are using the convex mirror? So this one, it is a which mirror? Plane mirror. It is a convex mirror. We know that. One question that arises mainly during the examination: why we are using the convex mirror as a rear view mirror rather than the plane mirror? If we are using the plane mirror, what will be happen? So that is one. So generally we know that plane mirror, when you place any object in front of the plane mirror, the plane mirror will be forms the virtual image. Convex mirror forms the virtual image. But what is the difference? Plane mirror, okay, the image formed by a plane mirror is always equal to the, okay, means the size of the image formed by the plane mirror is equal to the size of the object. That's why, what is the size of the object and what image is also same. But in case of convex mirror, okay, it will be forms the diminished image, means so the size of the image will be reduced when compared to the object. That is the first thing. And second thing, so the field of view of convex mirror is very high than the plane mirror. So now we are observing that if the plane mirror is used as a rear view mirror, what will be happen? Okay, like this one is the mirror. Then it will be, with help of this plane mirror, you can see the only this part of this area of the objects only, means behind us. So if we can use the plane mirror, it will be see which one only behind. But that one also, for example, a large truck or lorry is behind us, then what will be happen? So in the plane mirror, we cannot see entire the truck, just you can see the some part of the truck only, because of it's okay, the plane mirror will be forms the virtual image, its image is same as the size of the object. But in case of convex mirror, the field of view is more and so image will be reduced, nothing but diminished. That's why the truck will be so much large is there, but the large size of the truck is diminished, means size will be reduced, appears to small. That's why in the rear view mirrors we are observing that what are the vehicles are there behind us, that along with that vehicles surrounding is also appear because of this. Is this is called field of view. This is the field of view. That's why, so the plane mirror will be having the less field of view than the convex mirror, or convex mirror will be having the higher field of view than the plane mirror. And also, okay, convex mirror will be forms the diminished images. That's why a convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror rather than this one plane mirror. Why? Because it is forms the virtual, these are forms the virtual. But why you are not using this one? Because of two differences. One is, okay, the plane mirror will be forms the virtual image, its size is same as the object. But the convex mirror will be forms the virtual image, its size will be diminished than the object. And so its field of view more than this one. Because of up to here, what is there? Reflecting surface is there. That's why the rays are coming from this side object to up to this side. This total entire the area will be covered by the which one? Convex mirror. That's why convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror in which one? Automobiles. Next one is also. Okay. So why the convex mirror is used in street lights? In the street lights, we are observing that, okay, like this one is there, it is the street light. So in the street light, actually inside, we are observing that the surface is like this one. But in the mobile, okay, automobile headlights, like this one, means it is a concave. But in the street lights, the surface is like this one, the bulb is like. That's why when the light will be fall on it, then what will happen? that's why you are observing that. What is the use of the street lights? So you are observing that the light is coming from the street light, it occupies the more area. So the intensity of the light coming from the street light, it occupies the more area. Means for seeing the larger area, we are using which one? Street lights. That's why inside the street lights, we are using the which mirror? Convex mirror. Why convex mirror used? Because of it will be increased, it has the larger field of view. It has the larger reflecting surface due to that one. So when the light will be fall on it, it will be diverge the light in all direction, not converging. It is diverging. But in case of automobiles, if you are using the convex mirror instead of concave, what will be happen? So the convex mirror will be diverge the light. That's why. So means the intensity of the light will be not forced to one point. It will be distributed in all. Then you are not able to see the object in front of you clearly. But when you are using the convex mirror as a reflector in automobile headlights, convex mirror is converts all the rays. That's why you are observing that all the rays will be appears one long circle like that one, because of so more intensity of light will be fall only one point. That's why if the light will be fall on any object in front of us, it is appears very clearly to us.